Hello everybody, my name is Sheikh Nayab. From today onwards, I'll be sharing the Java videos. So welcome to the Java training. I hope you will enjoy my trainings. If you like it, please subscribe to my channel. So let's not waste the time, directly jump into the topic. So the agenda for today is, we'll see little bit introduction to Java, introduction of Java. So I will not spend a lot of time here because you would have seen a lot of videos, or in your academics you would have read about what is Java, how it came into existence. But I will spend maybe 1-2 minutes there. Then the second part is, so what are the things required? What are the things required to start Java programming? Third, so we will directly jump into Hello World program. So I will not be talking about platform independence, all those stuff, because in the first day itself you will not understand. What we will do, we will see what is happening in Java, and then we will in the next session we will see what is happening internally, and then we will compare with one of the language why it is Java is so popular. So let us start about introduction. So introduction in early 1995, so James Gosling and his team has been assigned in a project. So for that project, they wanted to develop some functionality. In that process, right, they wanted to use existing language, that term C++. But due to some reasons, they could not meet their functionality. So they could not achieve the project with the existing technologies. So they started writing a new technology, new programming language, which is Java now. So this is a small history. So initially Java has started with a Java 1 version, and then currently it is Java 14 version. So it is a long journey. So let's not spend a lot of time there, because so it will not be so useful for you guys. Now, the next thing is, what are the things required to start Java? So, to start Java, we need JDK. So, what is JDK? Java Development Kit. So, Java Development Kit is the JDK full form. So we need Java Development Kit. So Java Development Kit, from where do we get? So earlier JDK was with Sun Microsystems. So now it is with Oracle. So till 1.8 it was with Sun Microsystem. From 1.9 onwards, it was with Oracle. So Oracle, what they have made is, from Java they have made two flavors. So one is OpenJDK, so which is free to use. The other one is Oracle JDK. So this is enterprise. So what, this is free to use, this is not free to use. So first thing what we need, a Java Development Kit. So JDK we need. What is the second thing we need? So in the second thing, maybe we might need some editors like Notepad or Notepad++, anything, any editor. Second thing, one is JDK, so other one is editor. So these two things are required. So JDK and editor to start with. So I will tell you the process how to download the JDK also. So we have to go to Oracle site and then download the JDK, number one. So we can download installer or zip. Installer, which is a .exe file, or a zip file. So directly we can extract it, then it will be done. The next thing is, so once we get the installer, we need to install. So this is the process to install. So after that, what we need to do is, so we need to set the path. Set the path. So this is the second step. So for to start the Java programming, what we need to have JDK. And once we have JDK installed, we need to check all whether my JDK is working or not by setting the path. By setting the path. How do we set the path? So we have to go to my computer. This is my computer. From my computer, just right click on my computer, go to properties. From properties, go to advanced properties. And from there, environment variable. And then here, so we have to set path. Path as well as your Java home. Java underscore home. These two are the properties we need to set. Okay, this I will show you how to do it. So let's say we have downloaded the JDK and we have kept the JDK inside D drive. In D drive, we have created a folder called Java. So here we have kept JDK. So JDK may be 11 or 14, whatever the one which you feel you can put it. So inside this, there'll be mainly many folders, but importantly, there'll be two folders, bin and lib. So in bin, there'll be two important files. So one is Java C, other one is Java. So Java C is a Java compiler. Java C.exe it will be there, and Java.exe it will be there. So this is, these two files are very important. So Java C is a Java compiler. Java runtime environment. Java.exe. Java C is a Java compiler. Java is a Java runtime environment. So this is the installation and setting the path. So this, while setting the path, right, we, for the path, we have to give till the bin location. So D, Java, JDK, bin. D, Java, JDK, bin is the path in the environment variable. For home, D, Java, and then JDK. We should not give till the bin. So this is the difference. So we have to give only till JDK. So for path, we have to give till bin, because Java C is there in my bin directory. So this is the installation and then setting the path. Now we'll go to the third topic, which we have seen. So Hello World program. So directly I'm jumping into the Hello World program. This is, I'm writing a class, class Hello World. So here inside this we should have a method, public static void main. So as of now we just think that public static void main. This is args array, and then close the method. So open a flower bracket, and then here I'm writing system dot out dot print line. I wanted to print hello. Close it, close the main method, close the class, end of main. This is comments, end of class. So this whole thing I will be typing inside my editor. So I will name this as hello world dot java. So hello world dot java is my class name, the file name with which I will store. Where do I store? I will store maybe inside D drive. So I will create a folder. So in the D drive I will create a folder called practice. So inside my practice I have kept here. This is my hello world dot java. Okay. So now we'll see how to compile it and run it. So I'll explain each and every word here, what is the meaning of that over the course of in future videos. As of now, you should remember class, class name. This is the syntax, class and class name. So class name is hello world now. Class is a keyword. So we'll see what are keywords, all those stuff in the next video. So class, in the class C is small case. If you give capital case, it will not work. Java is case sensitive. And here public static void main, all are small cases. String, yes, capital. Args, so all small cases, it's an array. Args is an array. So, and then system S capital out dot println all are small. So this is the syntax. Java is a case sensitive language. If you give uppercase, it will not work. So this we have composed the Java program. So now we'll see what are the steps required to run the program. So where we have the Java program in D drive, we have a practice folder. And then we have our hello world.java, right? So this hello world.java. So in Java programming, there are mainly two steps. So one is compilation, and the second one is running. So these are the two steps we have to perform on every program. So this, for this I have to compile, right? So I have to open a command prompt. So go to start and do run, and then it will open a command prompt if you type cmd. So once you go to the command prompt, come to this directory where your source code is there. This is my source code, hello world.java. So I have to come to D drive and practice folder. So I have come D/practice. This is my folder. So now I told write Java C. Java C is a command which is part of our JDK. So when you hit the Java C, then that it will take the environment variables, and then from there it will understand Java C and then try to compile. Java C is a Java compiler. Then we have to give hello world dot java. So if you do this, enter, then it will, if there are no errors, it will compile and it will not give any output. So what it does is, after compilation successful, then it will create a file called hello world dot class. So this file it will create. So when you do the compilation it will convert the Dart Java program to a Dart class file. So it will generate a Dart class file where my source code is in the same directory. So once you see this output, so this hello world Dart class in the directory, which means your compilation is successful. Now this is the first part, compilation is done. The next part is how to run it. So we have to run now Java hello world. So this time we should not give Dart Java, so we should give only the class name. So this is my class name hello world. So we have given hello world. So if you give enter, what it will do, it will print hello. That is what we wanted, right? So that is what we have written in the system.out.println. So this is how Java programming we have to write. We have to compose the three steps. We have to write the program and then compile and then run it. So in the next video, what we will do, so we will see in depth how are we actually making a difference from other languages. I hope you like this video. So you can see series of videos from now onwards. So what I will do, I will create a complete practical as a separate video for this session. So you can see that session, that video also. By that you will have complete knowledge how to install JDK, how to install, how to set the path and then compose a hello world program and then run it. This whole thing I will make a separate video. So you see that as well. And as because my video length will become more if I put in one video. So in the next session, classroom session, what we will do, so we will compare Java with other technologies like C++. Okay, thank you. If you are not subscribed to my channel, please subscribe to my channel.